and the rest of you come up, the members come up, and I want you to raise your hand as we declare some things over your life. We're going to declare the anointing to drop finances over the people in this ministry. I normally don't even do that, but that is what God is showing me to do this morning. The anointing to drop finances. He said, I will bless the working of your hands. So all you need to know is what God has blessed you to do. What is it that he has blessed you to show you how to do with your hands? When you begin to do it, hallelujah, then you can call on the blessings of God. Now you can call on those that should be connected to you. He said, I will draw you, and I will also bless the working of your hands, and I will connect you with great men. Some of you need great strategies, business ideas to be implemented, so that when you go forth, the men and women will be able to see that you have what's needed. There's something different about you, that you're operating with an anointing upon you that no one else has. So we come today to declare the anointing of finances, a breakthrough, that doors be open, that everything that God has blessed you to do, that you shall do, and you shall do it well, with no fears, no doubts, in the name of Jesus. I declare that you can raise your hand right now. I declare in the name of Jesus. Bishop, if I go here with the anointing there, I declare in the name of Jesus, the anointing of breakthrough, the anointing of breakthrough to bring finances. We need finances to flow out of your hand, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. That is the scripture that I'm hearing from you, woman of God, that out of your belly will flow rivers of living water. Your water will not be stagnated. Your water shall flow. The anointing of God shall flow out of you. It will not be stagnated. You will not walk with fear. You will not walk with disappointment. God is saying, I'm going to flow out of you. That is my desire. That is my will. That's what I called you to flow out of your belly. Specifically speaking to you right now, glory to God. And Father God, I pray in the name of Jesus that you are unlocking the well out of this woman's belly, God. Oh, glory to God. That he's prophetically unlocking the well that you place your hand upon her belly. He is prophetically unlocking a well out of you, God, that you shall come forth. It shall overflow. It shall spring out in the name of Jesus. It shall be pure. And when others see this well that's flowing out of you, they will begin to question and ask you, how did you get to the place where things can come out of you the way that it is? But God said, I am prophetically speaking to you this morning, that you shall arise. You shall get to the place God wants you to be. Hallelujah, that you shall come forth.
Yeah. Thank you.
My body feels restored. I feel God is touching.
because this is what the word is saying. I am leading you beside the still water. I am leading you beside the still water. I know you've been walking by some water that's been trying to make you stumble and fall, trying to make you discouraged. But he said, this is the season that I will lead you beside the still water. I am restoring your soul. I declare that your emotions be restored. Your will be restored in the name of Jesus. And he says, as I hear your prayers, even the unspoken prayers, even the things that you don't say, even the things you walk around and you're just like, I don't want to talk anymore about it. I don't want to say that anymore. I see everything. I see your heart, and I want to fix it. He says, I'm fixing it. He said, I'm fixing it. I'm making it right. Leave it over to me. He says, just leave it. Let me handle it. Let me deal with it. You can't do anything outside of me anyway. He says, let me deal with it. That I hear your prayers and your supplication. I see it even in your time where you are quiet. He says, I can see your thoughts. I can hear what you are saying. I can see what you are thinking. There is nothing that is too far from me, says the Lord. And so, Lord, I am confirming some things to you. I am confirming some things to you. I am confirming some things to you. And even right now, I declare that right now, God will deposit another level of strength upon you right now. That God strengthen you, that God quicken you right now in the name of Jesus. Father, God, in the name of Jesus, touch your door right now, God. Impart it kind of right now. Another level of strength to go forward. I call on every discouragement right now. I call on everything that's trying to break you up and make you sad and make you give up. You will not give up. You will be strengthened. A new mind in the name of Jesus. I'm even hearing warrior God saying, I created you to be my warrior. I created you to stand firm. I created you to move and declare and decree. In the name of Jesus, I call out the warrior inside of you right now to come forth and declare the word of God. Hallelujah. Come forth in the name of Jesus. I call on strength to be upon you. I call on strength to revival. Revival in your heart. Revival in your mind. Revival in every part of you right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. He is leading you beside the still water. He is refreshing. He is blowing upon you right now. He is blowing strength upon you right now. He is blowing strength and power. Be confident in what I showed you. Be confident in what has been spoken to you. He said, even in your dreams, I tried to speak to you. Even in your dreams, I tried to show you some things. He said, believe me. He said, believe me. Amen. God bless the working of your hands. God bless the working of your hands. God bless the working of your hands. That he is depositing another level of intercession inside of you.
Right now, in the name of Jesus, that God is
the confidence and you know that God is with you, that your words matter. Hallelujah. Your words matter, that what you say matter, what you think matter, in the name of Jesus, that the enemy will not choke the word. The enemy will not choke your purpose. The enemy will not choke and make you pull back and fall back. And when God says that you are, God says, I'm making you over. As you walk with abundance, as you understand what abundance is, God says, abundance over you, abundance. I'm making you over. I'm making some things right. I'm doing some things. Hallelujah. I see him breaking yokes off of you. Know that God is doing something in your life. So when you speak to the earth, you speak to your house, you speak to everyone that you go and you declare and decree. Know that everything that God did in the beginning, he did it by his word. He saw it was God. He said, let there be light, as I appear. So when you speak, you know, whatever you call forth, it shall appear. You call forth your finances, you call forth your joy. God said, I'm bringing your joy back. I hear the word joy. I'm bringing your joy back. I'm making you happy again. Everything that is connected to you, that's trying to choke your happiness, that's trying to remove your peace, I prophetically speak to it in the name of Jesus. Let my voice echo in every room that you walk in, that you're walking with reinforcement, that you are giving your joy back, you're giving your peace back. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, I think the enemy even trying to put depression upon you, but I speak the life today. I break the chains of depression. I break the chains of mind battles. In the name of Jesus, the joy of the Lord is your strength. The joy of the Lord is your strength. The battle is not yours, it is the Lord. And you shall be still and see the working of God in your life. You shall be still and know that he is God. When you walk out of here, you walk out of here with confidence. Knowing that God is with you. God said that he made it today. He blessed the working of my hands. He broke the chains today. I got my joy back. I got my peace back in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. This is your season that you have your joy. I speak it like it's there already. You have your joy. You will be happy. You will have peace in the name of Jesus. His peace that surpasses all understanding shall cover you even while you're sleeping. Even when you lay down, you will feel the cool wind of the Holy Spirit blowing over you, removing everything that's trying to connect to you and bring you down. The wind of God to blow upon you. The wind of God to blow upon you. The wind of God, everywhere that you go, you shall feel the cool breeze of God blowing upon you, leading you. For I declare that you will be the manifestation of the Holy Spirit upon you, walking with you every step of the way. I said that even when you sleep, you will hear the angels singing. He has the capability to do that. He does that for me. When the stress of this world, the stress of the job, when I go to sleep, he allows me to hear a song. He puts the song in my spirit to let me know that he is there. He has not forgotten about me. And I declare that he will supernaturally do that for you. In the name of Jesus, begin to praise him right now, knowing that you're getting your joy. You got your joy back. You got your peace back. In the name of Jesus, I declare that everything that comes to stress you, the stress of this world, that you will walk around with such peace. You won't even worry about it. You know, God got it. That's what you got to wake up in the morning and say, God got it. God's handling it. God's providing it. God is with me. So I will not lose. And I declare he will bless the working of your hands. 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 In the name of Jesus. Woman of God, just declare the name of Jesus. God is already dealing with you. God is already moving. The angel of the Lord. That's the thing. When you have faith, God will begin to move in you, through you, even before the minister comes before you. For I declare the name of Jesus that new wind that God is blowing upon you. As I throw this oil upon you today, I know that God is begins to move upon your life as you feel the fragrance of the oil right now. I want you to know that this is a new place that God is bringing you, a new place where the aroma changes. The aroma changes in your house. The aroma changes in the places where you are. The aroma changes. God is saying, I am changing the aroma. Hallelujah. As you worship me, as you praise me, as you release the sound in your house. I am changing the aroma. The way you worship is different. The way you praise will be different. For God said, I am working you. For God said, I am placing my oil upon you. For God said, hallelujah, as you feel this oil today, you know.
God is going to give you an idea that something that you see this school needs. you see that's needed at the school, and go forward and implement it. Okay? Implement. She gets great ideas. Okay? She just needs to be encouraged and motivated. Wow. Great ideas. You hear me? You get great ideas. My brother wants that you can implement something new at your school. Okay? So whatever you see that's lacking, look to see what can you do to change it. So I pray the blessings and the workings of your hands will manifest this school year, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Am I okay with transition? Hallelujah. I declare that we shall bless the working of your hands.
Bless the working of your hands, and he shall lead you in the way that you shall go in the name.
Okay. So I declare that he shall bless the working of your hands.
So watch your cry.
Yes.
Okay? Yes. Watch your cry. I see dark forces around you. So it represents people. Watch your cry. Look for the light of God. In order to look for the light, you got to know the word, right? Because he is the light of the world. He is the light of the world. So I should not see dark forces around you, okay? So just watch. Walk with wisdom. Walk with wisdom. Walk with wisdom. The Bible says wisdom is the principle thing. That's the most important thing. Wisdom. If it don't feel right, if it don't look right, if it don't sound right, wisdom. I declare you will have wisdom. That wisdom will be very loud at the right time. And with wisdom speak, you'll be like, well, I don't know. Just start to step away from it. Okay? Dissect it. It's okay sometimes to just pull away and think. I don't know. There's a little gut feeling God gives you that we ignore a lot of times. All of us. That's wisdom. That's wisdom trying to, come. Okay? But I declare the blessings of God, the blessings of your head in Jesus' name, that he's giving you the wisdom, and I declare that these forces that I see, that they will have no power upon you, no power to get into your mind, no power to lead you, no power to distract you. I see the word distraction. No power to distract. You will not be distracted. That you, your mind will be in sync to the things of God, to the things of love. Whatever is pure, you do it unto the Lord. Whatever is right, you do it unto the Lord. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I declare in the name of Jesus the blessings of God will be upon you.
Yes.
Will bless the working of your hands and everything that you put to do, that everything comes in your mind to do, that you shall do it in Jesus' name with the confidence that you need in Jesus' name. So what is our next plan?
I don't know.
the glory of God. And so I declare that the Lord will give you strategy to open doors for you, and that you can do things like nobody else can, and that He will connect you with people that are looking for what you have. That's what we need as kingdom people, that God connect us with those who are looking for what we have, what we have. Your gift will make room for you, says the Lord. Your gift will make room for you. Where your treasure is where your heart is. We don't tap into our treasure because we dismiss where our heart is. So whatever you know how to do, you read books about it, you speak about it, you look for people that do the same thing, you connect. Your gift will make room for you. And I connect you with great men, and if you have something different, you have the Holy Spirit. So that means the prophetic will arise in you at the right time. Your gift will put you in a room with great men, and then you allow the prophetic, the spirit of wisdom, the spirit of knowledge, the spirit of understanding to arise in you. And I declare that over your life in Jesus' name, that He is giving you a boost of confidence in everything that you know to do, or you shall do it. You do it like you are the best thing that does it, the only person that does it well, that God will connect you with great men. What's going on? Are you working? Something going on in your job? I'm here in your job. Okay? So I declare whatever is happening in your job, that God will give you peace. To step out to your next level.
Yes.
Who's doing what they just worship, and as you begin to worship them in here, God will.
When you open up your mouth to pray, I hear something different now.
Thank you. This is out of place. This is out of line. offers never be closer. Many of you have received, I think all of us, have received personal prophetic ministry today. And I need each of you to be attentive to the word of God that was spoken over your life. I need many of you to write it down and keep it someplace where you can always refer to it. We've recorded, I believe, most of the prophetic ministry, and so we will make that available to you. It should be up online tomorrow, and we'll send the links to you. And so, but do not let this word fall to the ground.
Amen.
Let that word stay in the good soil of your heart and nurture that seed of the word of God and watch what God is going to do. Because I'm familiar with many of you, I can say that the prophetic word is very accurate.
Yes.
And so you can even say that you have a confirmation, because the prophet spoke and there was a witness to the prophetic word.
Yes.
And so all I'm going to say is watch and see what God's going to do next. Now, what we want to do, we want to take up a second offering so we can be a blessing to prophet Nelly Joseph. And so I am asking you to dig deep. When I say that, the other place where you put money that you set it aside. And I want to encourage some of you to give a good seed today. $20 or more if you can. But here's what I'm going to say. If you really don't have it, sow what you can sow. And if you really want to sow a seed and you don't have a seed, put up your hands so that somebody can put a seed in your hand. We want you to participate in this. If you really don't have it, put up your hands. Are we going to work on someone putting the seed in your hand? Amen? Put up your hands. I mean, if you don't have it. It's real. Don't put up your hands if you have it. If you don't have it, you don't have it. Now, keep your hands up if you don't have a seat. You do not have a seat. Now, can anyone help them with that? Put a seat in their hand. Any seat in their hand. Keep your hands up. Come on, man. I'm gonna push this today. Amen. Come on. Can somebody help these individuals? You just put a seed in there. Come on. Come get my seed. Make sure a basket goes to everyone. If you can do $20, if you can do more, we want to be a blessing to the Prophetess Nelly Joseph. Now, as we receive this offering, we're going to ask Chelsea and Abigail to come. We're going to pray for them because they're preparing to go into college. Chelsea will be traveling next Sunday to Southeastern College in Lakeland, Florida. Southeastern University in Lakeland, Florida. Abigail will begin the University of the Bahamas here on the island. But next year, she'll be scheduled to be transferred to Southeastern University at Chelsea. The two of them were in the same class together in our Seminary Baptist Academy. They graduated and did very well in school. The two of them did extremely well in school. And all of us are very proud of them. I'm just glad that they're sticking together. You know, it's not just going to be a year apart, but they're sticking together. So Chelsea is going to make the way for Abigail to come, all right? So she's going to pull the way. But we're very proud of them. So we want to pray for them. She'll come right here. And I want you to point your hands forward. And if you haven't given an offering, please make sure you just participate if you can. Point your hands forward as we bless them, as they prepare to go. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in the precious name of Jesus, we thank you for these two young women. And Lord, we thank you that you brought them to this place of maturity. And God, it is clear in their lives that they have a love for you and they love life. We pray, God, that now as they advance in this season of their life, we pray a special anointing upon them to enter into university. And we pray that as they begin university, that they will complete the educational assignment that is on their life. That, Father, that they will achieve the degrees that they need to fulfill your purpose in their life. That you would give them clarity to understand what educational courses should I pursue. That you will give them understanding to not only to study, but God, to do very well. We pray that they will excel in their grades so that they will get the attention of educators and open up doors of opportunities, oh God, doors that you will open, because when you open them, no man can shut. We thank you that every financial need will be met in every way. That God, that they should want for nothing, but God, that they will have everything that is needed at the time it's needed. And Father, we thank you that in this season of their lives, that you will speak to them more clearer than ever before. That you will guide them to walk the path that has been ordained by you. And Father, we thank you for a successful, successful period in university. And as a result of their education, a successful occupation and vocation that will bring honor and glory to you. We thank you, Lord. We bless them now. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Come on, let's give God praise. We're going to actually stand as we dismiss and we pronounce a blessing upon everyone. Would you stand? Please let that word of God stir it up in you. Don't let that word fall to the ground, like we said. God is going to do tremendous things. And I want you to keep declaring over Grand Bahama, it is time to build. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, as we prepare to depart from this place, we declare the Lord bless you, the Lord keep you. May his face shine upon you, give you rest and peace. May he bless everything that your hand shall touch. Yes. May blessings overtake you, so that what God does in your life will bring honor and glory to him and advance his kingdom. Be blessed in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 God bless you. Pray for our Prophetess Nelly.